Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Crashing Past Television Ministry from Hermitage, Pennsylvania. And we, again, are back with, really, this show here today. You're going to really love it. And if you have any children there, watch it, because talent is what God uses. And this lady, which I eventually will, Joyce will introduce, we crossed paths up in the mountains, if I remember right, at Doe and Ray Nemeth. And she did a little program up there that I liked so well. And she really liked our ministry because she just remembered how she met me. And that was when I was doing Moses and Dan Nasser and I, and he was doing Pharaoh. And a lot of people got touched by that little act, but we had fun. So Joyce, you wasn't with me at that particular time.
Well, we weren't married, but I knew you. I was there the night our friend Jerry Rhodes did a darling little skit. And stay tuned, don't turn it off. She does a beautiful job. Jerry, when you walked through the door, it seemed just like yesterday that you did that skit for us. So first of all, would you tell us a little bit about yourself and then you can do a little skit for us.
Okay, I would just have to say I went to Baptist church and I got born, you know, not born again, but I got saved, I'm going to say, because I got dunked and all that. And I really enjoyed church and stuff when I was in school. I mean, I was very true to God then, but I got out and I went my own way, and I didn't realize I was going my own way, and I ended up being married, and my husband and I split up, and I was raising three children, and I'm still a bartender for like a long time. It was extra money, and I did a couple extra jobs to raise the kids and stuff. And a friend of mine, which she gave me a prayer. And I'd gone all the way out to my ex's. He was out in Washington State. I drove out there with my children and drove all the way back because I just knew something was different. And when I got back, she says, "You seem like you're going through a lot." I says, "I am." And she gave me a prayer, which is the sinner's prayer. Mm-hmm. And I'm still a bartender, my landlord said that she would watch my boy, and the two girls were going skating with the guy that owned the bar. And I said that prayer, and the next day I get in there and he says, "Why didn't you turn the light off or on outside?" I said, "Well, I have a different shift." He says, "Well, you better the next time." And he started screaming at me. I said, "You know, I don't need to be treated this way." And I was walking out when he threw a beer at me and missed me, ready to push me down the steps, and it was radical on me. Nope, not one person in that place even stood up but one guy. And he says, "Come on, she's leaving, don't worry about it." Well, my kids in the meanwhile are in his car outside.
Oh my God.
So I go out, and next thing I know, they're ready to go to this gating thing, and I said, "No, you're getting out of that car right now." And he still proceeded to be rude to me. Well, anyhow, I left and went home with my children. So I was radically crying, and the landlord goes, "What is wrong? Did someone die?" Well, really, actually, at that time, I really died to myself. But anyhow, I know, and that was who died. But the gentleman did apologize to me, and I had just said, "I already forgive you." And that went on. Well, that showed me that God did not want me there. And then the next thing you know, I got a real good job as a senior center director, and I was kind of getting bored, so I started doing skits for them. And I was doing this one, the one lady was going to come and help me. I never did skits without anybody. I always had a person with me. And so this woman always helped me, and she couldn't make it this time, and I had like 50 people at this dinner, and I said, "What am I going to do?" So I did a comedy act out of the blue. And the next thing you know, I ended up going to church and started doing skits for the church fellowship meetings we'd have. And I was doing a few there. Then I started going all over the all the churches in the area and doing skits. Mm-hmm. People would call me and ask me to do them. And
excuse me a minute. You're from the Clearfield area,
yes.
Right? How far in that area do you do these skits? that people might
well,
know you?
Well, I've even been in Philadelphia. You know, I've been around in different places
so
that I've gone. And it was just like people started, you know, calling me. And then I, while I was doing these skits, I got to really get close to God. And he really changed my life. And I, like I said, once I got born again, my
when
whole
did you
life
get,
changed.
When did you finally, either were your background, was your mother and dad Baptist or something? How did you go
my
to
the
My
dad was Baptist. My mom wasn't. She was German, but she...
So when you say you got saved or whatever, but actually you weren't born again, you were just sort of religious in a sense, right? You
didn't sense.
You didn't commit your life fully.
I didn't understand it.
You
that's really what
it,
had
right.
happened.
Yeah.
And my preacher's wife was... always talk about the Holy Spirit, and I didn't know who that was. I didn't. And she went into a store and she goes, "Oh my, that's the Holy Spirit." And I go, "Who's that?" I mean, I'm 15 years old. I don't know. So, like 40 years later, on my own with these kids, and like I said, I end up just starting to do for the churches, and I did go away from the bartending and. You know, even when I did social events, I didn't really have the desire for anything, to drink and or anything.
So the Holy Spirit took you over.
Right. And he took me over in that prayer. And the great thing was that I just continued on. Mm. And now I'm also in a jail ministry. Mm-hmm. And in this jail ministry, I start out doing skits for them.
Show us one of your skits now, because I want to see this, okay?
Okay. The skit that I'm going to do tonight is, it's called Change. Born to be wild, looking for adventure, running down the highway. Oh, there's my phone. Hello? Hey, what you doing, Sal? How you been? Oh, yeah, I'm getting ready for a hot date tonight, boy. You should. Yeah, when we went out about 4 weeks ago, boy, there was nothing better than that, was there? Well, there was this gentleman, I guess you could call, or he called me up and asked me out. And, hey, I think it's great that I get to go out on a date. You know, it's always about the kids all the time and never going nowhere. Oh, I deserve to go out, don't you think? Yeah, he was that cute blonde, Yeah, right, I know. Well, anyhow, you kids be quiet up there. I'm telling you, I'm on the phone now. Get ready for your dad. Oh, kids, I can't believe them. I really get on my nerves. I can't wait till mine are out of the house. I've about done waiting for them to grow up. Yes, my husband, ex-husband, I never see him anymore. So I can't wait. I can't wait that they're grown up and gone. Yes, I know. I deserve better, man. Hey, it's my time too, you know. Okay. Oh, all right. Then listen, I got to get ready to go on my date. Oh, thank you. All right. Bye. Gosh, am I gorgeous. He's gonna really like this tonight. I'm so glad the kids are gone now and I can just have a good old time. Yes, a whole weekend without those kids. Oh, there's that phone again. Hello? Hi. How are you? What? Look at, I got a babysitter and everything. What do you mean? Listen. He hung up. Why? Why are they always so mean? Why can't there be a nice guy out there or something? They're all jerks. I can't take it no more with these kids alone all the time. There's that phone again. Maybe it's him again. Hello? Who is this? What? Who are you? What do you mean, am I alone? Yeah, I'm alone. I'm alone with three kids, and I can't take it no more. Would I like a better life? Well, why not? What are you talking about? I don't know nothing about this Jesus. I don't even know him. What are you talking? A prayer? Me? A prayer? Oh, I. Okay. Who is this? Can't you tell me who? Is this a survey or something? Okay, I'll say the prayer. Okay. Well, will he hear me? Okay. Heavenly Father, I know I'm a sinner. What's that? What? Okay. All right, I'll keep going. And I know you died on the cross for me and rose that third day. And please forgive my sins and come into my heart and become my personal Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you. Wow. That was a different person. And I don't know who it was. Oh, there's a phone again. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible. Hi, how are you? Well, yeah, I know I haven't called you in a long time. I know, I'm really sorry I haven't, but my life has really changed. Yes, I know. Well, anyhow, I don't know, but he didn't show up. Isn't that something? Well, my life has totally turned around from that time. And, you know, well, I don't know. I got this phone call after that. I don't know who it was till this day. I just don't know. Can't figure it out. But I did this prayer. It's called the Sinner's Prayer. And my whole life changed. My whole life. My kids and I are getting along. In fact, my husband and I are taking him to church. And our life is, what? No, I'm not better than you. No, I didn't get all religious on you. No, no, I got Jesus. That's who I got. I got a relationship with a total different loving person. And my children and I were all in this relationship. Well, please don't feel that way. Well, okay, Sally, maybe someday you can go to church with us. Okay, bye. Boy, it's really sad that you really do have to turn from your old ways. Thank you. And I should have been standing up, changing clothes. I had all kinds of things planned for it.
Yeah. But you got the point.
And I got wanted to get the point over. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. And life gets changed, you know.
So you've been doing this now for how many years?
Oh, I don't know, 15?
Years. So if somebody in a church would like you to come to their church, right?
Yes.
You don't even worry about finances, you just come, right?
Yes.
And then, of course, their love offerings or whatever, right?
Right.
Do you have any skits for children only? Have you gone into that?
Oh, I can. Also, I feel that the Lord gave me the gift of writing them. You know, he writes them. You know, he gives me, I've done plays with children. Mm-hmm. My granddaughter did them for 5 years, skits with me, when she was younger. And I've done all different kind of skits.
How did you, it's amazing, you called me after maybe 30 years or something. What happened that you called me? That's why you're on TV today. How did you happen to remember my name or crossing paths or?
Well, first, I was on your show a long time ago, and that was about 10 years ago.
Yeah.
Yes. I've known you maybe longer than that, and I don't know what made me call you. I just know I felt that maybe I was not, I want to be obedient, for sure, to the Lord, and I believed he always gave me that gift of writing him and doing the skits, and but then I had gotten into a jail ministry, which I got away from the gift a little bit, not a lot. And I saw you on TV again one day and I was amazed. I was so thinking how blessed he really is to still be out there, you know, and I just called you.
Yeah. See, and 'cause that day I was sitting there getting all my speakers. You know, and I thought, well, I tried to hear from the Lord, and all of a sudden the phone rang, you know, and there you were. And I thought, well, Crossing Paths likes to do things different.
Yeah.
And you see that today, right? And why not?
Yeah.
Why can't we be different?
Right.
Why can't Christians just act like we want to act?
That's right.
You know, not the wrong way.
Right.
But in God's love.
Yes.
Right. Yeah, now, love. I think you made your point very clear, but women out there are lonely. Mm-hmm. They got three children, like you said. You had, thank God, for the Baptist Church. You see how we uplift the Baptist, the Methodist, mm-hmm. the Catholic Church,
yes.
right over? You had that seed planted.
Yes, yes.
See, the Bible says some plant, some water, but God gives the increase.
That's right.
And we crossed paths there, and evidently you remember seeing me out there dressed up as Moses, right?
Yes.
And that's years ago.
Yes.
And I've just recently done that into another church. And I guess they really liked it, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I just want to say out there today, people, this woman is a perfect example that has went through trials and tribulation. Joyce gets all these calls. Some women aren't very, they're just wrong in their beliefs, and they continuously pray for everything but normal things, you know, parrot or whatever, you know. And I know that's, they're lonely. But that's what it's all about. Mm-hmm. Jesus never turned anybody away.
Amen.
He never. Amen. And that's why Crossing Paths has been a success in this valley. And this is one time I'm going to say something that a lot of people, I'm not bragging, but we are on 35 states now. We are on around 200 cable companies. And I'm not afraid to say this. I'm 86 years old, and some man recently asked me, why are you still doing TV shows?
Why not?
And you know, that's exactly what I said. Why not?
Yeah.
You know, I know makeup helps. Because I always tell that station joke about the lady that come to me in a restaurant. She says, Mr. Reed, you look better on TV than you do in person. And then I thought for a minute, and I got angry for a minute. And I said, well, you use makeup too, don't you? And then I repented. I thought, I'm going to let her get away with that. But why not? See?
Yeah.
And we have the opportunity today, people. And my recent thing that Joyce knows and many knows, I try to witness everywhere I can.
Oh, boy.
I take a quarter up at Aldi's. And I always wait till somebody is coming to get a new one. And I say, here, take it. And they want to give me a quarter. I said, no. You just take it. She said, why? I said, then you can watch me on TV. Now, that's one way I do it. Mm-hmm. The next thing, too, she says, I tell you, I'm a Christian. She said, what do you mean?
There he is.
You got, take the time to tell them about Jesus.
Amen.
Most of them will just walk away. They just gotta do something, you know, and that woman is there for a reason. So don't think that God doesn't see everything we all do here today, you know?
Yes.
There is what we are going to say here.
The sweet thing about Don is he never argues with anybody. He will not try to argue you down on a fact or what you think is a fact. He just kind of real gently recites the scripture and drops it. And that's when your Holy Spirit that we
yes,
talk about,
yes.
it begins to make you think, you know, why did he say that? What's God trying to tell me? And if we listen and if we're obedient, God will explain it. He really does. He'll send somebody or somehow. The Holy Spirit always manages to get your attention.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
And I
know my wife and I travel an awful lot and speak in all churches. I never once asked for a certain fee like you. Never will. Never took a salary in 18 or 40 years that I've been saved here. But that little thing you've done brings me into the song here today that we have. You know, Jim Leese and Donna Leese were very much of my life, especially when my wife Donna had Lou Gehrig, and they would come every Friday night and bring fish for us for years, and then all cooked and all ready to go. And Jim and I have known, I knew him after I got saved, and he wasn't a Christian either until he got saved. And we were both belonged to the lodge one time, and we got out of that because God told us to get out of that Masonic lodge. And he has a voice. And this song, and when you talk about the women that are lonely, this the Lord gave me this song for the program, okay? It's beautiful. It says, people need the Lord. And isn't that the truth? People need the Lord. And if you're out there today and you're hurting, and your husband took off, or your wife took off, or you've got a problem, whatever it is, you listen to this song by Jim Leese from West Middlesex, PA. He's a pastor now, Barnstone Ministries down in Pulaski, Pennsylvania. And he is out singing what the Lord has done in his life. Picture yourself, like she sat there, she's crying. The man turned her down for a date. She was all ready to go. And a stranger by the name of Jesus, one of his disciples, called and led her into a sinner's prayer. Listen to this song now. People need the Lord.
This song that I'm about to share is one of Don Reed's favorite songs. And it is really the whole reason for Crossing Paths Ministries, because people really do need the Lord. Every day they pass me by, I can see it in their eyes. Empty people filled with care, headed who knows where. On they go through private pain, living fear to fear. Laughter hides their silent cries. Only Jesus hears. People need the Lord. People need the Lord. People need the Lord. People need the Lord. When will we realize people need the Lord? We are called to take his light to a world where wrong seems right. What could be too great a cost for sharing life with one who's lost? Through his love, our hearts can all the griefs they bear. They must hear the words of life. Only we can share. People need the Lord. People need the Lord. At the end of broken dreams is the open door. People need the Lord. People need the Lord.
when will we realize that we must give our lives cause people need the Lord. We don't need the Lord.
When you support Crossing Paths, you're helping to release the power of testimony. There's many people who know about God, but they don't know Him personally. They don't know His true nature, and they don't know His heart. The stories that we bring you each week testify to the power of God and to the love of God. Through these testimonies, people all over the country are getting to know the Lord and developing a hunger to know Him more. When that relationship becomes alive, it's clear to see that no person or no situation is too far gone for the power of God.
I like to share with people that it's very important to know who you are in Christ, because that day, if that was me laying there, I know that I would have missed heaven.
Revelation 12:11 says, "And they overcame him," referring to the devil, "by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony."
God is still the same. He's still this. God's word is still the same. They say times are changing. Times are changing, but God is still the same. It's a no-brainer for me. You don't have to have a doctor degree to know that God is good. He loves sinners. He just does not like to sin.
When you partner with Crossing Paths and sow a seed into this ministry, you are helping us get the power of the testimony and the gospel over the airwaves. This will help people understand better who God is and connect them to the plans He has for them. Please call us today and support this vision.